if Dylan was here, he would be like thrashing the place because he's losing money all over the place, right? And yeah. I for one time agree with him. The tax system right now, it's something, right? It's not manageable like this, man. I have to feed my kids. I have 12 kids at home. How am I gonna feed them if I lose 10% every time I need to take out some money? It's bullshit, man. Hey, man, can you not smoke inside a hospital? Jesus.
Yeah.
But I mean, those changes sound kind of stupid, not gonna lie, but hey, who am I to talk? I'm just flipping burgers.
I don't think I should be taxing my savings in my bank, yeah.
Yeah, it's mad. I mean, where's the mayor right now? He needs to be piping up, man. He needs to be fucking fighting for the fucking city, bro. But he's nowhere to be seen, bro.
That's what I'm saying. That's all we need, guys at home. We need a strong leader mayor that can fucking abolish these fucking bullshit taxes and get something better for us instead of taking money from
fuck
the hard working
people. What
do
you mean? I'll fucking run for mayor. I'm for the people, bro. I'll run for mayor. What do you mean?
Would you abolish the taxes?
Bro, I'll run for mayor and I'll get the city fucking square and fucking ready for the fucking people, bro. No 10% tax on that bullshit, bro. I'll run for it. Give me the application form. I'll run for mayor right now.
What would your legislations be?
You shouldn't be taxed on your savings, bro. End of it. Should be fucking 0% tax. And then like a fucking 2% or 3% tax
zero.
On your current account, bro.
Zero.
That's true.
So put it out there, bro. Get this on the fucking news, bro. Draco is going to be running for mayor.
Draco, what's your full name, sir? What's your full name?
Draco Swift. I'll even... You know what? Fuck it. I'll even take the mask off, bro. Oh. Draco Swift. Look at this face. This is going to be the fucking future mayor of this city. Fuck him. I'm running. Fuck taxes. I'm here for the people, man. Fuck the government. Fuck the feds. I'm here for the fucking people, man.
Yes. This is... absolutely beautiful. You heard it here, folks. Draco is running for mayor. Will it be good? Will it be bad? Who the fuck knows? We will see. Thanks again for the interview, Draco. This was fucking amazing.
I'm cool with whatever is going on now. It's not really affecting me personally because I got two jobs. I mean, I wish I had just one job, but I love both my jobs, so... it makes me work harder. I'm a workaholic, so it really doesn't
affect
me.
Amazing. So what do you think about the fact that if you want to take out some money from your savings account, they can take out 10%? How do you feel about that?
Wait, they're trying to take 10% out of the savings?
They already do that. If you want to take out 1 milli, they will take out 100k in taxes.
No way. What the fuck?
If you want to try it.
You're gonna take
1 mil, you know?
No, okay. 10%. Per few days, okay? You know, per couple of sundowns and sunrises, we already get taxed on our main one, okay? If that shit continues, if we're literally getting taxed to keep our incomes up, okay, that's insane. What are we gonna do? Carry big load of cash on us by risking our lives on that case? So we don't get taxed. The economy is already going crazy, man. Like you can't afford to, like you said, if I have to pull, for example, 4 or 5 million out of a savings to buy a house, I have to give away almost $500,000 away to the government for them not to do anything about
what? Talk your shit.
Yeah. So that makes no sense. No, I'm going to say, bring that shit down. Even if it's 1%, I'll be fine with that. But 10%? That's crazy. I didn't even know that. No wonder whenever I pull out a savings, shit goes crazy. My math don't add up. That's insane. I mean, they're basically saying the second you're poor, you're comfortable. The second you're rich, you're uncomfortable. I don't get that.
It's fucking crazy, bro. It's absolutely bonkers and nuts. They should fucking abolish this shit because we are just hardworking men, alright? You know what I mean?
Yeah, of course.
Just trying to make bread. And
do you guys even get paid? I'm gonna ask you a question. Do you even make bread?
No, you don't even get paid.
Nope. So the fact that you guys are already your job is a voluntarily job, that's insane, man. You guys should be. You know what? government, if you're hearing this, if you're watching this, okay? All that tax you're taking, maybe you should pay the people that are doing the job to entertain the city. You guys should just get money in general. You guys aren't even getting paid. Okay, the camera guy here, I don't think he... I think he wants to, you know, be able to afford a house. That ain't fair. If you guys are, you know, giving the weasel news of the city, you know, then the city has to pay you.
Listen, listen. What's your name? What's your name, sir? What's your name?
My name is Zio.
Zio? Zio, yeah. Sir? You said some beautiful, amazing things. Nobody said anything good about Weasel News.
Yeah, no, I appreciate the work you guys do, man. You guys are out there hustling, putting your lives in danger.
Okay.
I mean, let's.
I'm trying to get my business up, and maybe I can help you out with the scoop. So, you know, I'm new to the city and whatnot, and I deal in drugs, money, guns, all that stuff. I'm a Vagos, trying to come up on the come up, you understand? Mm-hmm. But one of my gigs is, if someone can bring me a person and I can sell them, I'll split it 50-50 with them. And I already have trapped two people, and one of them became the first lady of Grove Street.
How much is a person worth?
I got $100,000 off a person.
Ah, damn!
I'm telling you, that's big news. I need the publicity.
So listen, if I give you someone, we'll just chop them off in little fucking parts and they will be dead forever?
Nah, they wouldn't be dead forever. They could become a gang member. It depends who you sell them to, you know? Like, I sold the lady and her stepbro to Grove Street, and they became a Grove Street gang, and that lady became first lady of Grove Street, like the president's wife.
Oh, damn.
So, you know, it just depends who I sell them to. They could become a farmer. They could become a housewife. They could become a dad. They could become a, you know, whatever they want to be. It just depends who I sell them to.
They could be becoming like a house husband as well.
Yeah.
Could be like a personal assistant.
I could sell you a personal assistant.
Oh shit, for you?
Well, you have one already. Well, yeah, I could find someone and then try to sell them to you.
Is the person you're selling like a cousin or some shit?
No, I'm not selling no cousins. I'm not selling my family. I'm selling other people's families. What kill you more? The taxes are what kill you on the inside. The drivers are what kill you on the outside.
And they break your legs and they break your dick and they break your arms and they break your...
That's what fucking happens.
Legalize heroin.
This is complete bullshit. I've been paying my taxes for the last 60 years, and now they come along trying to get me to pay 10% to take out my fucking pension? You gotta be fucking kidding me. So that's why we're here, to burn this shit down and fuck the courthouse. No, I'm only joking. We will not burn anything down, but we will protest until we get what's right.
I couldn't hear
you. We'll do what we want, fuck the police.
You're trying to protest, not riot.
Bro, where is the fire? I don't see anything.
I'm protesting peacefully on top of a police car. You do not have the right to tase me, sir. I protest and this is a peaceful protest.
Do not aim your gun at him, sir. He did nothing wrong. Like a fucking gun
to you. Don't shoot him. This is America. Don't shoot him.
The taser gun, sir.
You don't need to tase me, boy. I'm just protesting peacefully.
protest.
He's part of the autistic LGBT handicap community. If you should.
How are you gonna say you're gonna protest?
Not hurt anybody. I don't.
Fuck the police, coming straight from the underground. Yeah.
Fuck yo, the police.
Hey, but the police are here to join us. They're not here to fight us.
It's just a, oh shit!
Colin, I've just got to go pick something up. I'll be back shortly, alright?
Fuck the police!
Alright then.
Charlie,
how much is this? Oh my god! Oh!
It is.
So, I've come to protest with you lot, and then you treat my car like that.
Yeah, that's what I'm talking about, buddy. Drift that, baby!
I'm out.
Hey, officer, can I ask you something?
What the fuck?
I'm not keeping it peaceful. Wait till these government officials turn up. That's not a threat, that's a promise.
£1,000 fine.
For what?
Because he's threatened to blow my cruiser up.
Yeah.
And he vandalism threatened to blow my cruiser up.
He vandalismed.
Hold on. If anyone else wants to fuck around and try to destroy my vehicle, you can fucking find out.
Is the gang coming?
Gas prices too high. Don't mind the taxes, but $3,500 to fill your gas tank up is insane.
Yo, you want to come down here? You want to protest? But you also want to get a good bite to eat? Go on down to Tony's Tacos right there. Fucking get yourself some carne asada tacos. They're fucking delicious.
Fuck yes. This is Weasel News coming live from the courthouse. As you can see, where there was at first a peaceful protest that turned into what seems to be, you know, quite a rough riot. Cars were blown up, people were unhappy, signs were flashed. It was not the best day for Los Santos, as the people are not happy. This is Weasel News live.
Crackhead Chew, yeah. How does this whole thing make you feel?
These taxes made me turn to drugs, man. I need my fucking fix every day and I can't fucking afford it.
This is Weasel News and we're coming to you live today here from the courthouse. On the fountain, of the edge of the fountain here, we can see a Mr. Saint Avery. And he seems to be a little bit upset as he got a couple of words to tell us about the increased taxes, about this hobnockery that's been going on in the city. Mr. Saint, what do you have to say for all this?
Well, I understand that everyone's worried about this 10%. And it is a lot, and clearly, you know, it's a pretty simple fix. You get rid of a 0.1%, we're all happy, right?
Yeah. Easy. Yeah. Okay.
And I don't understand the whole thing. I don't understand why there's even a problem here. We could fix it by just getting rid of a 0. It's that easy. Police out here acting like everything's a joke, dancing behind me.
That is true.
You know?
That is true. Oh my God.
There's just so much going on. And like, if so, you know, there's $10 million houses in the city.
Pray for tax, right?
If I wanted to go buy myself a $10 million house, I'm gonna want to put it in my savings account, so I'm not getting taxed on it constantly.
Exactly.
Right. And so while it's sitting in my savings account, I end up finally, after weeks and weeks and weeks, months and months of grinding to get this $10 million. Now it's sitting in there. I want to pull it out. I want to get me this big house. I've been dreaming about it. This is all I've ever wanted. But I can't.
Oh,
because
my
10%
God.
Is being taken out every single time. So
what
if I pull out 10,
fuck?
I need at least 11 mil to pull out 10 mil. And still, again, like you said, the percentage is still going to roll over to that extra million. So now I need an extra 100,000. And that 10% is going to roll again. Now I need an extra 10,000. And then again, I need 1,000, then 100, and so on. And so now I'm sitting here almost. I'm paying what? Almost. Well, I don't want to do quick math on it, but you know, like $11.1 million on a $10 million house.
Oh my God.
11.1.
Breaking. As you can hear here from Mr. Saint Avery, a very unhappy citizen of Los Santos, he explained it to us in quite some detail. This tax rate is pushing up prices. It's affecting newcomers into the city. The tourism industry is getting hit by this. And not only the tourism, but the citizens, the people of Los Santos is unhappy. How will this be dealt with? How will government answer this question? The citizens clearly want to know. Not only are they unhappy with the tax rate, but also the gas prices. This is absolute hobnockery. And we as the citizens...
Cheetah bandits. What do you guys want?
They want you to take his...
We're not going to take the reporter hostage.
We are doing this because...
Oh yeah, sorry.
Taxes. Oh yeah.
Taxes.
Yeah, taxes. This is the perfect time to actually talk about this, guys.
Oh, man, fuck it. We're doing a bank robbery. We're two guys as hostage right now. You want to go and talk about taxes?
Listen, why you guys have to say
we gotta
taxes?
Have money to pay our taxes?
Making me walk here. I don't mean to. I promise.
Speak your shit, gang. Speak your
and
shit.
The gas prices. The gas prices went up. It's because I shit my pants. Yeah. Calm down.
That's why we need to do this. We are forced to use finance because everything is good. The government is taking too much.
Holy shit.
So today we are here talking to the bystanders of the robbery here in the Flicker, here in Los Santos. And his name is...
Mole Corleone.
Yeah, Mole Corleone. And how do you feel about what just happened, Mr. Mole Corleone?
So basically, I just flew in, right? I'm in my apartment, I'm making breakfast, I leave, I get in my car, and I'm driving down the street, right? I turn the corner. I see a group of butt naked men taking people hostage and robbing a bank. I was like, oh shit. Shit's going down. So I'm sitting there watching it, watching shit happen. That shit was crazy, man.
Before he searched you?
Amazing, amazing. What do you think about the fact that they were butt naked? What do you think about that?
To be honest, I might have to try that. I might have to. I don't know. Not sure, to be honest. That was like innovative. That's new. They're creating something new, and I respect it.
Did you ever rob a bank, sir?
Huh?
Did you ever rob a bank, sir?
No. I've never robbed a bank in my life.
Did you ever think about robbing banks?
Especially.
Well, now that I've seen a group of butt naked guys, I'm inspired to rob a bank butt naked.
Amazing! Amazing! These people are inspiring people to do crime. Amazing!
Maybe another bank robbery.
Big T, get your hands up! We're getting our friend out of jail! Oh shit! We're getting our friend out of jail, man. It's okay, bro. It's okay.
Get your camera. I'm giving her fries. Get your camera.
Thank you.
It's the robbers. At least Ryan got it.
Guys, see you at home, bro. Someone tried to take me hostage, but someone saved my life. Crazy stuff all the time.